Good afternoon, all the respected juries, organizing team of International e-conference, and all the participants present here. I am Pitambari Bhagat, and my topic is a review study on wildlife forensics. I am from Shri Mathuradas Mohata College of Science, Nagpur, from Nagpur University. Next slide, ma'am. So, starting with the introduction. Wildlife forensics can be broadly defined as the application of forensic science to legal concerns involving biological resources. Its goals are to use scientific procedures to examine, identify, and compare evidence from crime scenes and to link this evidence with a suspect and a victim, which is specifically an animal. Wildlife crimes like poaching, possession, illegal wildlife trade, and cruelty against animals now considered fourth largest organized crime in the world. Many rules and regulations are made to control wildlife trading. Under this act, many zoos, national parks, and sanctuaries are set up. So for decreasing wildlife crime, there is a need of wildlife forensic laboratory. The wildlife forensic laboratory have various units, and the use of DNA analysis technique is most developed for species identification. These units involved are, the first is chemistry unit, which deals with the cases related to toxicology and poisoning. Second one is the pathology unit, which deals with the serology. Third one is the molecular biology unit, which deals with the analysis of serology. And the fourth is the question document unit for the analysis of license and papers. And this involves the crime scene investigation also for identifying the species. Involves the biological evidence is matched with the species and identification of the morphological trait. Next slide, ma'am. Review of the cases in wildlife forensics. It is the cases for the identification of the species, illegal hunting, and wildlife poaching. Identification of the species involves the related with wildlife was received for the postmortem to resolve the identification of species. For example, identification of Indian black buck through fins. Illegal hunting involves the for the species of meat, skin, or bone detected with molecular forensics in Brazil. For example, capybara species is Hydrocharis. Wildlife poaching is the study related with poaching of wildlife in Italy used in forensic investigation, example wild boar. West Bengal of India conducted a case study avoiding false offenses which deals with unidentified cooked meat, for example, greater short throat plug. This case study exhibits the value of molecular diagnostic techniques using a genetic marker to decipher the morphologically altered materials in the wildlife forensic cases. Many case studies related with poaching were identified by using ELISA technique, assessed based on PCR and real-time PCR for the species identification. DNA extraction and PCR amplification were done for the identification of the species, in which universal primer sets of cytochrome B and 125 rRNA genes were used to amplify approximately 400 base pair fragments of both the mitochondrial genes. And the last is conclusion. This review highlights molecular approach of wildlife forensics, that is DNA detective, genetics and wildlife biology, role of FITES, Convention of International Trade in Endangered Species, differences between human and wildlife forensic genetics, application of DNA technology in wildlife forensics, DNA typing in wildlife crime, recent developments in species identification, importance of forensic science in wildlife investigation, wildlife trafficking, current and future directions of DNA in wildlife forensic science, forensic DNA testing, forensic test DNA. These techniques are helping for forensic scientists and wildlife persons to detect animals related crimes. Here is my references. Next slide, ma'am. थैंक यू. प्रकृति रक्षति रक्षिता, दैट इज नेचर प्रोटेक्ट्स इफ शी इज प्रोटेक्टेड. थैंक यू मैम.